Hello, my friends. Another... You might not be able to tell this by all the light that's coming in these windows, but today has been a rather gray and gloomy day. And so, of course, a good cup of hot coffee. Oh, it's even steaming. Yeah, and I've been going through things here. Look at this. Ration book from World War II. You had to have stamps to be able to buy things. Because every commodity was rationed for the war effort. This little box is one of my mom's old things. It came from, I'm not sure, the box, whether the box came from her ancestors or my dad's ancestors, but inside is all kinds of old things, newspaper clippings, and a lot, 10 or 12 old books. Here, for example, the Holy Bible. This says the name of one of my ancestors here. It's quite extraordinary having all these things here and having to decide what to do. I want to show you something else that came around. We were out at the room where the parents had stored all kinds of stuff, and we were emptying the thing and throwing a lot of stuff away and trying to decide what to save. And I decided I just had to save these dishes. Excuse me, I'm gonna block the view again. Get my cup of coffee. I just had to save these dishes. Even though three of them are broken. But except for that, still warm. Here is a vision of rustic life painted on a coffee cup. And here's one of the plates that wasn't broken. See, it has this picture painted on it, a little scene with children playing in front of, look, there's chickens and a dog or a cat or something, somebody coming around the corner in a carriage. There's the little old cottage. And there's another cottage up in the woods, up there, up the hill. This is all painted on the plate. This is what it says on the back. Now, I went online and I was able to find replacements for the three broken plates. And so I did something I really don't want to do. I spent money. I spent about $30, and half of that was shipping, to replace those two broken bread and butter plates. They could also be used for salad. And the one broken saucer. Now, it may seem bright to you, but when the sun is shining, this room is unbelievably bright. I would have to put down the blinds to get a decent image on the inside. But now, it's so dark, you see the light completely illuminates everything. Because, see that? That's just a light in the kitchen is almost brighter than the sunset, sunlight. There will probably be no sunset today. Now that looks bright out there. And I must admit, it looks bright in the camera viewer, but it's about 1/10 of as bright as it gets when the sun shines. We are having what we here in San Diego call June gloom. This year it came after May gray. There was a time a few years ago when we had this all summer long, but usually it gets dry and sunny and hot. The weather's acting real weird out there. I understand some of you have suffered from tornadoes and floods, so I really don't have anything to complain about not having as much sunshine as... Yeah. Well, that's it, my friends. I'll see you next time.